What's up, friends? Welcome back to The Nerdy Filmmaker, and today we're talking about turning your outdoor footage from this to this using ND filters. Now, what is an ND filter? Well, very simply, it is a piece of glass that cuts the amount of light that goes into your camera. When it comes to mirrorless cameras, like the one I'm shooting on right now, you can get ND filters like this one that just actually screw on to the front of your lens. Now, why would you want to cut the amount of light going into your camera? Well, if you're shooting outdoors and you want to open up your aperture, maybe as wide as it can go, I have some lenses that go to 1.8. If I want to get that shallow depth of field, well, it's going to be letting in way too much light. Your ISO might be already as low as it can go. You don't want to ramp up your shutter speed. So the only other option is to reduce the amount of light coming into your camera using ND filters. So these filters can come in a variety of strengths. They can go from one stop, two stop, three stop, six stops, all the way up to 10 stops of light cuttage. And they rate these using one of two systems. Either it's going to be multiples of 0.3, so one stop would be 0.3, two stop would be 0.6, and six stops would be 1.8. The second way to rate these is with ND 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64. What are these numbers? Well, those are 2 to the power of something. So let's say you want a 4 stop. Well, that would be 2 to the power 4, which would be 16. So ND 16 would be 4 stops of light. The ones I have are ProMasters. I'll leave a link in the description if you want to check them out. Now, the other option that you can go for is what's called a variable ND filter. And so let me see if I can get focus on here. Whoa, there we go. And what you do is as you turn it, it actually gets darker. Wow. Now look, you can see my face. Ah! So in the case of a variable ND filter, it can range from, let's say, one or two stops all the way up to 8 stops. But there is a downside towards getting a variable ND filter is that generally they'll have some like artifacts that come along with it. A lot of the times as you go to the darker ends of the variable ND, you'll start to see kind of like X patterns or kind of weird darkness patterns that arise, especially if you're looking up into the sky. These kinds of issues aren't really present as much on regular ND filters. So if you do shoot a lot outdoors and you're thinking, hey, this might be a really good upgrade for my shooting setup, you might have several lenses that all have different thread sizes, so a different kind of size at the front, and your ND filter won't fit in to all of your lenses. Well, a tip I can give you is instead of buying an ND filter of each strength for each lens, it's to look at something called step-up rings. So over here in my little lens package, that's where the other ND filter goes, I have a bunch of step-up rings. And what a step-up ring is it's a little ring that threads onto the front of a smaller lens and then allows for bigger attachments to go on top of it. And in fact, not only are these a really efficient way and inexpensive way of being able to use your filters, any filter across multiple lenses, a lot of the artifacts that you'll see in, let's say, a variable ND filter or a cheaper filter usually happen around the corners. So if you're actually using a larger filter on a smaller lens, a lot of the times you can actually avoid those things. And so my suggestion would be if you are looking to get ND filters or any filters, look at what the largest lens that you have is, or would be if you're thinking investing in another one, and buy the filters for that lens. After that, get step-up rings for all of your smaller lenses so you can use the larger filters on your smaller lenses. The only downside to this is that if you do start to use larger filters on smaller lenses, your lens hood will probably no longer fit on that lens. So if that's something that's really important to you, you may want to consider getting the appropriate sized filters for each lens. That's it, friends. Simple Dimple ND filters. Love them. I tried shooting some outdoor stuff without them and quel désastre. Quel désastre. I had to really close the aperture quite a bit and it lost any of the kind of quality depth of field that my lens provides. So if you want to use your lens to the fullest capabilities outside, ND filters. That's it. Bye, friends. Thank you.